A new thermophotovoltaic cell generates more energy from heat than a steam turbine. A solid-state thermophotovoltaic heat engine created by MIT researchers may run at greater temperatures and generate more electricity from heat than a typical steam turbine. According to MIT, their groundbreaking solid-state thermophotovoltaic heat engine may be able to generate more energy from heat than a conventional steam turbine at a quarter of the cost and with no moving components. Major effects on grid-level energy storage and future power plants. The primary source of energy for heating water for human consumption and steam turbines is heat. Burning coal, natural gas, or even concentrated solar energy can generate this heat. This method of generating electricity has been in use ever since Charles Parsons first coupled a steam turbine to a dynamo in 1884 and licensed the idea to George Westinghouse. Over the past 150 years, it has evolved into a mature, well-optimized technology with well-known benefits and drawbacks that have proliferated around the globe. Effectiveness is one of these restrictions. Although some have been able to convert as much as 60% of the heat energy from a heat source into electricity, the typical turbine runs at closer to 35% efficiency. Heat is another restriction. For example, turbines cannot operate at temperatures higher than 2000 degrees Celsius due to the moving parts. These numbers come from a team of MIT scientists who have been developing a replacement. A thermophotovoltaic, TPV, heat engine that doesn't have any moving parts and has now been tested successfully in a tiny 1x1 cm prototype, maintaining an efficiency of over 40% over a temperature range between 1900 and 2400 degrees Celsius. According to the team, this represents a significant improvement over conventional TPV heat engines, the majority of which operate at about 20% efficiency, with the previous record being 32%, and that, in the right conditions, it is an energy harvesting technique that is more efficient than turbines. On the essential premise that heat is delivered, absorbed, and then released by an absorber emitter substance, which on the other side emits photons, a thermophotovoltaic heat engine runs. An adjacent conventional solar cell collects these photons and turns them into usable power. The MIT team greatly improved efficiency by making a few minor changes to a variety of key variables. First, the temperature of the heat input. Above the temperature at which turbines stop operating, this gadget is designed to function. This enables the employment of solar cells designed to fully use these high-energy photons as well as absorber-emitter materials with larger band gaps, which absorb more energy and produce higher energy infrared photons on the emitter side. Then, the photovoltaic cells were layered, with the first layer made to transmit high-energy photons at higher voltages and the second layer made to accept low-energy photons with efficiency. A mirror is used to reflect photons that travel through both layers back onto the absorber emitter so that any that are outside the ideal ranges can initiate the reaction and maintain the emitter's thermal stability. The study team highlighted the importance of the TPV efficiency of 40% in developing TPV, a heat engine technology that can compete with turbines, as they presented the findings of their groundbreaking testing. TPVs may even be more desirable than a turbine because of the possibility for lower costs, faster reaction times, less maintenance, simplicity of connection with external heat sources, and fuel flexibility. 40% efficiency already outperforms typical American turbine-based heating systems. The possibility of next-generation low-emission power plants that can extract more power, more affordably from a combustion source, is increased by the state-of-the-art heat engine technology, which run in a temperature range suitable for natural gas or hydrogen combustion. When creating green hydrogen, such a facility might not release any nitrous oxides, but it also might not release any carbon dioxide. The research team highlights that even at this level of efficiency, these TPV heat engines may quickly convert thermal energy grid storage projects into an economically viable method of storing and releasing renewable energy at the grid scale. The approach used by the team involves heating up banks of heated, well-insulated graphite, which will act as an energy storage medium and require extra electricity. Large clusters of TPV heat engines would be used to convert the energy back into electricity when needed for the grid. The researchers predict that the efficiency of this heat battery will fall between 40 and 55% on a round-trip basis. The efficiency of lithium batteries is expected to be closer to 70%, which is considerably less than that of other battery types, according to the researchers. The researchers predict that TEGS will be competitive anywhere the TPV heat engine can function at about 35% efficiency, even if the initial cost per unit of energy will only be one-tenth that of lithium batteries. These TPV heat engines are the final piece of technology needed to enable extremely affordable grid-level thermal energy storage. The crucial final step in proving that thermal batteries are a workable idea was the development of thermophotovoltaic cells. This is a huge step towards a society entirely free of carbon emissions and the widespread use of renewable energy. The technology has the ability to significantly reduce carbon dioxide emissions from the generation of power and is both safe and advantageous to the environment throughout the course of its full life cycle. The efficiency record set by this team will undoubtedly soon be surpassed, because turbine costs and performance have already reached full maturity and are close to the top of their development curve. There aren't many opportunities for improvement. On the other hand, the development curve for TPVs is just getting started. As a result, there are several opportunities for TPVs to increase their effectiveness. Examples include raising reflectivity, decreasing series resistance, and enhancing efficiency, using, for instance, less expensive feedstocks and substrates. This kind of efficiency step change could result in significant progress in the search for carbon-free energy. We want to learn a lot more about these solid-state heat engines in the coming years.